Yeah. All right, McCullough, thanks. Well, a young woman's statement about body image has sparked a social media debate. 18-year-old Stella Boonshoff posted this photo of herself on Tumblr. Stella said she posed in her underwear to spread the message about body acceptance. The picture was picked up by other blogs, and it's now been viewed more than 4 million times. On the Today Show this morning, she explained why she came forward.
There was no way to justify the bullying and the torment I endured as a child and as a teen. And it took a lot of years of self-searching to understand that, like, this isn't right. We don't have the authority to judge other people's beauty. We don't have the authority to make, you know, assumptions about other people's health based on the way they look.
Well, Stella says she didn't expect so many people to see the photo. She says the response is overwhelming, but mostly positive. So, how do you stop bullies and help their tormented victims erase those emotional scars?
An international activist and author has come up with a three-step plan based on her own experiences. Gabriella Von Rey is the author of With All My Might. So thank you so much for joining us, Gabriella.
Thank you for having me.
Tell us a little bit about what happened to you growing up.
What happened to me is I was adopted by Dutch people and really lucky to be adopted. But through the adoption, you end up being in the 60s in a predominantly Caucasian environment where you look like me. And now that's great because we're all really like a big melting pot.
We are,
but
yeah.
We weren't back then. So I stood out. So my bullying experience are more about culture, are more about race, are more about stuff like that. People were kind of wondering why I was so dark.
What happened? What did they say to you?
Peanut butter. The Dutch really love their peanut butter, like you guys. Mm. And so they, you know, for years I wouldn't eat it just because people called me that.
Let's talk about solutions. We've been hearing about bullying for years, but it seems like nobody has been able to perfect the right solution, the approach to this. You have a three-step plan. How does that work?
It works if everyone plays. And the problem is they won't always play. So the first thing is we know either a bully or a victim, we know them. They could be adults, they could be children. So the first thing is I'm asking everyone to become an active witness. And to be an active witness, you have to talk. Meaning if you're a parent, if you're a teacher, just a friend, a simple friend, you know that your friend is in trouble. You see it day after day and you do nothing.
You gotta speak out.
Speak up. Go to someone. It's not tattletaling. Help your friend.
All right, so
that's one.
Number two.
Two, the signs. The signs, the child is isolated, but the bully has signs too. It's acting out in a totally different way. They're mirror images of each other, you know, the bully and the victim. They both have such issues about self-esteem that they need to hurt someone else. Now, obviously the victim doesn't hurt anyone, but the victim doesn't feel good about who he or she is, right? And they feel very insecure. And third, and not least, and the most important is I would like to see the parent, the teacher or a counselor, and the bully and the victim in one room. I know that sounds a bit daring, but I am daring. And the reason that I'm saying that is when I see the experience and we do it, there is a real solution in that room. The bully and the victim, it clicks. They see something happening. And it is so amazing. One suddenly understands the other. And it really stops. I'm not saying they're going to be friends.
But how do you get that message across? You're traveling across the country, right?
For me, my biggest problem with is to get the parents to come and listen. I need the parents. I know they have busy jobs. I know they have two jobs. They're all juggling.
And you're actively doing that,
I'm
though,
really
right?
I'm actively doing that. I want them to come and speak to me. I really want them to come.
You know, the problem is that I have three kids, and
okay.
I've had two kids that were bullied, actually.
Okay.
But, you know, they'll come home, they don't say anything to you. They don't. But what happens, I mean, like, my son was bullied terribly in New York City, and it was my daughter that came to me and said, by the way, Christian told me this. Like, he came home with a fat lip one day. I was like, what happened? Oh, nothing, I just bumped a pole. I said, you did? I bumped a pole? Yeah. And, you know, I didn't follow up on it, so it's hard to get the kids to talk to you a lot of times. They're ashamed.
I know, but as parents, we notice slowly in isolation. You notice grades. There are lots of little signs, and it helps to have siblings.
Siblings help, yeah.
That helps, but it helps to talk every night to find out, because we are not kind to each other. We adults are not kind to each other. So how can we teach it to children? We ourselves, you know, we're tired, we come home, we forget that they're listening over the Wi-Fi and all the little gadgets. And one other thing that I've noticed really, really a lot, and I really hope that this segment will help parents to watch this more. Social media.
Yeah.
It can be very positive, can be very negative.
It sure can.
I want to say about the negative part is that hands go up in third grade. They have Facebook. I'm astounded.
Well, they're not supposed to, though, Gabriella.
No,
not
I know.
In third grade. Thank you so much. Again, your book is With All My Might. So we sure appreciate you
coming
in today. This is fantastic. We very much appreciate it.
Thank you.
Have a great day. Do you like to ski, by the way?
I do.
But listen to this one. It's time.